Hello and welcome to the Non-Greg Sterlis, Greg Sterlis Show. I'm your host, the Pemazon, except only the substitute. Your host, the Pemazon.
Yes.
And we also
have hello.
The lovely John.
I was not to tell you, it is very strange, you know, we are here on the TV. It is great.
It is not strange at all, we do this all the time. You should know better by now, son.
Yes, you are a very strange creature.
Oh, I was scrolling through my phone here today, and
Don is just not a bright boy.
If you voted for Donald Trump, you're an idiot. You're just an idiot. I'm sorry. And this guy is an idiot. This is what he said. For all the money we're spending, NASA should not be talking about going to the moon. We did that 50 years ago. They should be focused on the much bigger things we are doing, including Mars, of which the moon is part of. Defense and science, which clearly shows this person knows nothing about science. The moon is not part of Mars.
The moon is part of everything. Cosmic.
We would be so screwed if the moon was part of Mars and not part of Earth. We'd be really screwed. There's like things that happen because of the moon.
Everything is a part of everything else.
Where do you think we mine our
all come from the same place.
I think you should tell him that we need to go to the moon to mine some cheese.
Provolone.
He'd probably believe it because he's a goddamn idiot.
Yeah.
No, the moon is made of the best cheese, which is American cheese. It's the best cheese ever made.
The moon is disgusting. It's just sitting there. Full of nasty cheese.
American cheese is great for those sandwiches with the Wonder Bread and the American cheese that you toast. I can't eat those anymore.
Yeah, those are really good.
Those are really good.
I think American cheese is good for certain
things. They were
so
bad for you, but they tasted really delightful.
They're good. You know, I like grilled cheese. I don't think grilled cheese is very good without American cheese. Or, I mean, maybe cheddar.
Cheddar. Cheddar's good.
I mean, I like, unless it's like nasty Kraft. Like, I mean, you got to get like at least like, you know. Some
cheddar's my favorite.
Cheddar is one of the best cheeses.
It's got to be sharp, though. You know what
it,
I really
it
hate?
The American cheese. To make American cheese great again, you can't get the cheese product.
Yeah, that's so disgusting. My dad used to buy that, and it would just like oily leak all over the place. It was so disgusting. My dad always buys the cheapest thing. You got to save a dollar, son. Here, it's only 35 cents. It's like, yeah, Dad, but it's not food. It's just like orange coloring.
Yeah, they're no longer allowed to call it cheese food.
What are you, a wimp? Just eat it.
The Wegmans, like their extra sharp cheddar, it's not sharp at all. It's not.
No, it's not.
It's really a disappointment. Wegmans, step up your cheese. Step it up. Your sharp cheese, not sharp. It's very mild.
Yeah.
Did you do that for like Americans or something, thinking, you know, oh, they can't handle the sharpness of the cheddar. Bring it down.
I don't know. I mean, come on. Wegmans usually has pretty good standards. I think somebody.
They do, but it's not sharp at all.
It's not.
Make cheddar cheese sharp again.
The Topps generic cheddar cheese is sharp.
Which is strange, because I don't know. I don't know. Whatever. Yeah.
Oh, I did a thing where I did a little Google search.
Yes.
I thought it was very telling. I don't know. Well, never mind. It's okay.
I hope your phone isn't in your cosmic space bag anymore.
I took it out. Where's my... Because Leonardo's sitting on my space bag.
Grab a cat. The magic revenge.
Yes, I got this little bag for my phone. It's Leonardo sitting on it to protect it. It's like waterproof, and you can still use your phone through it. But then Leonardo sat on it when I took my phone out, so I can't use it right now. But it's pretty safe up here. There's a floor on the ground, so if I drop my phone, it should be okay.
Yeah, I don't know. This rug is. Where do you get one? It's the color of like baby puke green.
The thrift store.
Oh, well. Okay.
Yes, it came from the thrift store.
Yeah, it's pretty. It's, when I think of, like, ugliest color ever, that's pretty close, but, you know, that's why I like it.
Because it's the ugliest color ever?
Yeah, it looks like nasty, dried up pea soup or something. But I love pea soup.
In one of the Kurt Vonnegut books, he described a color called baby shit brown, which was like a greenish brown color.
That is a very specific color. Yeah. I mean, like, I've seen lots of babies that poo that color.
They do, and it's gross.
Yeah, it's pretty nasty.
It's just like, when you have to change diapers that look like that.
I couldn't wear diapers as a kid, at least not regular diapers. My butt was allergic to it.
Oh, that sucks. Did you have to wear cloth all the time?
I did.
Aww.
I could only wear cloth diapers.
I think I had to do cloth, too, just, but I don't know why.
Ooh, we had the same diapers.
We had the same butt coverings as babies.
Yes, isn't this delightful?
It's a delightful revelation.
Oh, yes. We're both Year of the Snake as well.
We are both Year of the Snake. It's true.
Snakey cloth diapers.
And then, but you, I am a Scorpio and you are a Capricorn.
Yes, yes, it's true.
I don't know what's your birth year number?
My birth year number? What do you mean?
Yeah, there's, I'm going through all the, well, whatevers, it's numerology stuff.
I know about numerology, but I don't know what it would be. I don't know. There's a lot of weird stuff with numerology that Yoko Ono was warning John about, and like, John believed it, but he really didn't know what he could do about it. Of course, you know, it seemed like it kind of.
1989?
Yes, yes.
Plus, no, not time, shit. 1989 plus, no, what, oh my god.
I'm 3 million years old, apparently.
That's a plus symbol, clear. Why is it doing that, John?
I don't know.
Plus.
I don't, what does that mean?
I don't,
what are you trying to add? I
could
probably
working.
Do it in my head. 1989 plus 1989?
No.
What are you trying to add? Because I could probably figure
it out. Well, it should work. I need a calculator. I'm really... Oh, maybe I have to use this...
Oh, I think that... What? Just go on the Google. See if there's a calculator on there or somewhere.
That is
Google
disappointing.
Google is a calculator. Just Google it.
I don't actually have the Google browser on here because I changed to an iPhone from my
Huawei,
which I love. But iPhones just
aren't hacked.
They just record
things,
so well.
Aren't hacked by, yeah, unlike my previous phone, which was a Huawei. And I don't know. Can people tell me? I had the. When I would click on YouTube, it would keep the little window open. Like, it says you're supposed to pay for that on YouTube. And it's like, pay for this and you can keep YouTube going. And mine did it. And I know they got in trouble for stealing intellectual property. Yeah, it was a great phone. It had a great camera, but it just did not handle loud volumes well. So when I was filming bands, it was... No.
Yeah,
good.
This phone does sound really good. We just recorded a band today.
We recorded three bands.
How do you get the film in that little thing?
It's very tiny. You gotta run it slow so you don't run out.
So tiny.
It's
micro,
so
micro
tiny.
Film.
Micro.
Nano film.
Nano.
Sounds like bananas. I always think of nanners.
Nanners? Nano, well, here's another calculator. Let's see if this... if I don't know, let's see if this one works a little more responsibly. Okay, go ahead. Plus, what's
plus
that?
What?
Plus 12. You're born in December 8.
Yes.
Plus what day? 27.
Yes.
Equals 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So you're a number three a number three life path.
What does that mean? That sounds bad.
I don't think it's bad. I don't know.
I don't know.
Four is bad.
Four is very bad in China.
This house is a four, by the way. The address is a four. Uh-oh.
What? I like four. Four is my favorite number. It seems so nice and even and clean. And.
Yes. And then you have to do your... let's see.
I don't want my life path to be three. Three sounds... It's not enough.
I don't really know. I just know that's...
So
I know
too
how
many
to do
at the
it.
Same time. Like, at least give me a nice, clean four.
A nice clean, maybe your name's a four.
But I don't want any sixes or fives, because I don't like odd numbers. Why are they so odd? And six? I don't know.
I'm a little worried. I don't want to disappoint you. What if it comes out?
That's okay. don't mind me. I'm just too stupid. Kind of. I don't know. I don't trust six. And I also don't trust five. Because why is odd? Why are they odd?
That's the number of the place we're moving to.
What?
A five.
I mean, I already live there, so.
So you're okay.
I'm
all right. Okay.
I mean, I'm here now. I mean, that was a long time ago. That was 25 years ago, so I was pretty young.
You was a baby.
I was a baby.
Oh, baby.
I was a very strange, hairless baby with cloth diapers.
Whoa. That was not on screen, but
I was also not even 3 pounds.
I was not a giant baby. I was like 5 or 6 pounds, despite my large size now.
You still could have beat me up.
With a life path 3 are the most artistic in the bunch.
Oh.
They can always find ways of creating the most beautiful things, such as art, music, literature, etc.
Delightful.
Well, that's got to make you feel better, right?
Yeah. I'm less suspicious of that stupid 3.
Mine's an 8. Eight is like the unlucky one. It's like the unlucky one.
Let me look into my cosmic space bag.
Oh, okay. Look at that space bag. It's like the... It's like...
As a life path of 8, you live to make an impact on the world through your drive and ambitions. You are a person of authority.
Authority
always wins. And material wealth is. You will master the art of being successful in your career of your choosing.
Ah, there you go. That sounds pretty good.
My name is an 11.
An 11.
My 11, name is.
The 11 is a life path number of the healer.
The what?
A healer.
Oh, a healer. Okay. Huh.
Oh, hey, if anybody else watches weird shows besides this one, look up the George and Keiko show. It reminds me exactly a lot of the Greg Strela show because it also features a magical talking duck. And
what?
It does. And
sorry, Dudley.
Yeah, the George and Keiko show.
You gotta find
good.
That duck and kill it.
It's basically the same thing, but with like.
I thought I was healing one.
With like this dorky guy and like this Asian girl who looks super uncomfortable with the dorky guy. And, like, the duck's always like, yeah, you gotta stay away from Keiko. And he's like, nah, Keiko's cool, right? She's like, hey, no, you are not invited to my wedding. And it's very funny.
So what's this in your hand?
I just wanted to bring up, since I like to talk about things, this is the newest album from a band I saw but yesterday called Sleep. This is their newest record called...
I like Sleep. Yummy. Sleep is good.
It's true. This is their newest record. It's really good. It's all about the themes of, like, exploring. Okay, so basically the last album was about how I forget what they called them. I think they called them the Marijuanauts as they went to explore Jerusalem. But this is about how they go into space to explore space, and they go to different planets. They discover planet Iomia, which is... Okay, basically Sleep worships Black Sabbath as, like, a quasi-religion. So, like, all these songs are either about weed or Black Sabbath. And if you look at all these little cool things, it looks like it's all breakfast, but there's all sorts of cool little hidden things. Like, I'm trying to find them all, but Tony Iommi's face is on the toast. You got Bill Ward on the milk. And then you got Butler for Geezer Butler. And then there's all sorts of weird references. But the whole album is about space exploration, but like in weird sorts of trippy ways. It's a very, it's my favorite album by Sleep. Other than maybe Dope Smoker, which was the last one. I don't know. I like this one more than Dope Smoker. But I love Sleep. I have this shirt from them, and I think it's a delightful band. And I think this is the coolest album ever. If you like things about space and a weird spacey theme, it's very cool. It's called The Sciences.
Is that how you spell your middle name?
E-L-L-I. No, there's two T's.
Oh, okay. So that's the wrong number. All right, so never mind.
And that's the cool tour edition. So I don't know. I highly enjoy Sleep. That was the loudest concert I've ever been to. Besides one really annoying one where it hurt. But that one, I don't know, Sleep Live, you really feel like it's a crazy religious experience. They bring you to that riff-filled land like it says in the lyrics. You just like kind of zone out and it's like, it's so crazy. I don't know. Sleep is like, what?
Your name number is a 4.
That sounds bad.
You said you wanted a 4.
No, I like 4, but everybody says the 4 is bad.
There's the 4 is the worker. You do not like taking shortcuts and often feel the best way to do things is through decisions and perseverance.
I don't know. I'll
you
just do whatever.
You can see right through all those get-quick-rich schemes. I consider them to be wasted time, because
it depends on hard,
old-fashioned work.
What I'm doing, like if I'm doing something...
Was there two L's in Elliot?
E-L-L-I-O-T-T.
Okay, I got it right, yes.
Yeah.
Just like it.
I'll definitely cut corners on like stuff like my comics or like music, but like if it's something I don't care about, then I don't really care that much. It's like whatever.
Well, examples of Life Path 4s include Bill Gates, Oprah Winfrey, Donald Trump, and Frank Sinatra.
Damn it, Don. Get out of my numerology this. But, well, what is yours? Oh, you're an 8, you said.
Well, that's
my name is an 11.
You told me something
about that. This is the Life Path number.
Yeah, there's
different numbers.
Different numbers. There's what the letters of your name add up to, what your birthday adds up to. There's other stuff too. I don't know it all.
Yeah, I don't.
I know there's those too because I'm an 11. An 11.
11.
Oh,
11.
11
degrees outside.
11. So I can recommend something, I guess. I've been listening to a podcast on my new phone, my little plastic bag that everybody's making fun of, but I can keep my phone safe in it and I can carry
your bag?
A little iPhone 6S or 6S Plus that someone came up to me and was like, oh yeah, I need a new phone. Mine's garbage. You sold me a 6S. And I'm like, I just bought a 6S, lady. Don't make me feel bad. Hers was cracked, to be fair. I can use my phone through my little bag.
Yeah, it's nice. She thinks I don't like it. And
you
I
don't
just
like
it.
You said
nice.
It's ugly. You said
it
it's
is
ugly.
But it works. It's not like hideous. It's not like heinous.
Bill said like, it was heinous.
Well, that's because Bill has strong opinions on this.
Yes, he has strong opinions. But at any rate, it's true. It's not as high powered as my phone that I was using while allowing the Chinese to spy on me. But it does shoot the videos very well. Yeah, see, I can just, there we go. How delightful is that? It's just, there we go. I got my phone. It's great. And I can still listen to it. And if I drop it or I spill fluids on it, it's safe.
Or you can take it into the shower.
I can take it into the shower. And I could totally take it in the shower and it would be fine. Nothing bad would happen.
Yes,
so, yeah.
Yes.
Make fun of my bag.
I like how both of our shirts today. You've got that wonderful...
I know.
Floppy disks.
I thought people would be like, that's a cool shirt. But most
check
people ignored it.
Check out my 8-inch...
Oh, I've got a lot of...
Damn,
Dudley, whatever.
I like it, world. Just like I like my plastic bag, and I love the spec cover that's on my iPhone. It's very pretty.
Yo, you want to hear my music on floppy disk? Look it up. I've got songs on floppy disk. You can hear it for free. It's cool.
Also, I've been saying, you know, I guess half-heartedly recommending podcast Clark's World.
Yeah,
Clark's World, which is sci-fi. But I also been listening to something called Cocaine and Rhinestones, and it's about country music. And the guy is so... My bags are crooked. Why are they crooked? pretty much.
Dad.
No, it's really good. The guy is like so adamant,
yeah, he's
too.
So into
he kind of like is half yelling everything he says, which is kind of impressive. But he's really thorough, and that each episode is really quite long. So I'm sorry, I'm seeing how crooked my hair is.
That's okay. Goosebumpy my arm is for some reason.
Goosebumpy arms. But he's wow, it is.
I don't know. Why
he's super thorough, and he talks about, you know, it's all about country music. So if you absolutely hate country music, don't listen. But it's still very interesting, you know, to hear the different ways things evolved, and he definitely traces them back. Yeah, so it's really super fun, and like most episodes are pretty long, so you've got a while to listen, which is also nice.
Yes, yes, this here, I really enjoy it too so far. I haven't heard too much, but I don't know.
I'm carrying my little bag phone around listening.
Yeah, it's good.
Hang it on things and listen. Yes, it's good.
It's all good.
Great success.
Great success, yes. But I don't know. It's all good. But yeah, look up that sleep record. It's really cool. The guy literally, like, I think actually worships Tony Iommi. It's really funny. Like, he's like, everything's, he signs every post on Facebook with praise Iommi, and he talks about the Iommic Pentecost and stuff. It's really funny. It's like, dude, all right, Tony Iommi's great. I mean, Tony Iommi is in two of my favorite bands. He's the guitar player for Jethro Tull and Black Sabbath, but
yeah. Oh.
Whatever. It's like, dude, he's just this Italian dude, guitar player.
It's fun to say Iommi.
Yeah, and I love Tony Iommi. He's one of my favorite Iommi. Players.
He's
very
fun.
Only having three fingers. I mean, he's a good guitar player.
What? He's only got three fingers?
Yeah, right before Black Sabbath first went on tour, he was still working in a metal sheet factory and cut off two of his fingers.
Oh, that blows.
So he can only fret so many things.
Wow. Hopefully he has maybe long fingers to help make up for.
I read his whole biography. He said he basically just kind of like does whatever shapes he can with the fingers he's got left.
That's cool.
He got inspired by Django Reinhardt, who also only had three fingers.
Really?
Yeah, Django only had three fingers.
You get all these facts. Facts.
Well, I read a lot of things.
You do read a lot of things. Facts.
Tiny Tim was right-handed, but he played ukulele left-handed because he thought it would give him seizures, even though he played all his other instruments right-handed.
Wow. Yeah. Was there any reasoning he had for this?
Probably the same reason he thought he'd catch AIDS if he didn't wear diapers.
Oh, okay. So
probably
yes,
no.
Those kind of reasons. All right. But the thing is, you know, like when you're playing an instrument, you're using both hands, so I never understood that. You're using them both, you know?
Yeah, I don't. I have no idea. I don't understand it. But I don't know. Tiny Tim's an odd fellow. I mean, because if you look, if he's playing guitar or banjo or anything, he's always playing righty. But as soon as he puts on the ukulele, it's lefty. He claimed it gave him seizures, but that doesn't make any sense. But Tiny also never lied about anything. Like, I don't think Tiny knew how to lie. He just was so bad at it, so maybe it did.
Huh.
He was so direct about everything.
Well, did he have a seizure disorder?
No, not that I know of. I mean, he just, like, thought it would happen.
That's very
But, I mean, Tiny will sit there for, like, 3 hours and talk about the impurities in a bar of soap, so.
I don't get seizures, but I do get migraines triggered from flashing lights, and it's not very fun, so. I don't know. That just seems improbable, though.
Yeah,
if you're playing instruments one way and you're like, oh, I have to switch one this way, you know, it doesn't seem.
He's a strange guy. There's a really funny video where he's talking to some wrestler and he goes, you're the Dairy Queen. And he's like, what? What? And he just steals Tiny's ukulele and he starts bashing it. And Tiny starts crying.
I would cry if someone bashed my ukulele. I might just kick him or something. Yeah. That's probably more likely. I would too.
Yeah.
Probably kick them or something.
I think it was staged, but I don't know because Tiny, I don't know if he ever figured this stuff out. Maybe. I don't know. Tiny's a really bad actor. Even though he's in a lot of movies and he's in Roseanne and stuff.
Leonardo's coming for you. Oh.
Damn a kitty. But I don't know. I do love Tiny Iommi. Like,
face the camera. Make grunting noises into the microphone.
I've seen Black Sabbath.
He's so stinky.
I've only seen it with you, but I saw Sleep last night. That was like seriously like a religious experience. I come out of it like Jesus Christ, those riffs just like go through you. It's so crazy that he starts going on. He's like, ride the dragon through the crimson lie. Flap your wings under Mars' red sky. I'm like, yes, yes, yes.
Yes. Yes.
It was very intense.
Yes.
The roundabout.
Roundabout.
Yes.
You mean, yes, I love yes.
Oh, I love yes.
Yes is so awesome.
Yes is one of the best bands ever.
I remember, like, in the early aughts, and suddenly people were like, Yes is cool. And
whatever.
Well, no, suddenly it was cool, and it had been so uncool. And I said to someone who said that, I said, oh, I'm so glad it's cool now, so that, you know, people don't make fun of me when I say I like it. And then the person got really mad at me anyways. I was like, you know, but this is the same person who I played the song Fearless by Pink Floyd to. And they were like, oh, my God, that's so cool. What band is that? It's cool. I was like, wow, Pink Floyd busted.
I mean, I don't know tons of Pink Floyd. I like it with Syd Barrett. Like, I like that one song he did, Set the Controls at a Heart of the Sun. That was a fun one. But I'm a sucker that anything sounds kind of, like, Arab-y. Which, I'll Sleep also sounds super Middle Eastern-y. Because I think the main guy, Elsa Sarnos, is pretty Arab. I mean, I don't know for sure. He looks exactly like me in, like, 50 years, but... I love Elsa Sarnos. The Weedians is just such a cool concept. Just, like, these people that travel looking through the spiritual connections of weed through, like, Jerusalem and then, like, space and planets and stuff.
The Weedians?
Yeah, that's who's on my shirt. This is one of the head Weedians. That's the whole concept of, like, a lot of their songs. It's like the Weedians travel.
I didn't know that. You're like, there's going to be so much pot at this show.
Oh, yeah. It was a giant bong. The whole theme of everything is weed and Black Sabbath. It's what every song is about.
Well, yeah, okay. It's good to have a focus.
Pretty every sure that's a giant bong he's got going on there.
Every song ever... What was that?
That's every song ever made.
It's true.
Some are about other things.
No, they're all about weed. Or Black Sabbath.
Or Black Sabbath, okay.
Or just Ozzy.
Ashker's one.
Shit, I was writing songs about the Snow Queen in modern day. I thought, but I guess it was really...
That's about cocaine.
Oh, okay.
There's a really great song about cocaine called Snowblind, which they cover. It's amazing. My eyes are blind, but I can't see. The snowflakes freezing over me, yeah. I love that song. Oh, System of a Down also does a cover of Snowblind, which is amazing. The lead singer of System of a Down looks exactly like my dad. That's really weird. I wish he had the same money. Yeah, Serge Tankian looks exactly like my dad. It's very strange.
Well, there was that White Lines. That's a Coke song. Yes. White Lines. Da, da, da,
oh,
da,
I remember
da,
that.
Da,
he showed me that.
Yeah, that's a really rap song.
That's good. I like that song.
It was.
I don't know. Whatever.
Fresh. Fresh. Go something, something, something. I don't
I
know.
Like go out of my way to make sure my songs are about, like, literally nothing, like, deep, because I think it's funny if my songs are, like, you think there's meaning, but there's not. Like, like Papaya Chunk, people are always like, yeah, but what's it really mean? It's like, nah, it's just about going to the store, because that's funnier. I go out of my way to be as non-edgy as possible. Because I think it's funny. Like banana chips. Like, no, it's literally just about eating banana chips. Because that's funnier.
Which is funny because it seemed like, you know, when something came up. When banana chips first came out, Everybody thought they were health food, but they're really kind of garbage.
Bad for you.
They're garbage.
But they're
don't
tasty
do it.
Garbage.
Don't do it. Bump, bump, bump.